Hello and good morning, and welcome to the Morning Metaphysical Report. My name is Lysander Xanthus, and in the background we have commentary from Eliza Nanos, aka the Kitchen Witch.
Good morning, everyone.
So today we will be sharing with you the day's astrology, numerology, and some other helpful information for you to bring into your spiritual practice today and to encourage your spiritual practice, whether you are novice or expert. I like to get us started with a mini grounding and energy clearing to help establish good habits. So we are going to release any energy we might have picked up from the day and also slowly wear down any of our own negativity that we're trying to work through. So wherever you are, whatever you're doing, as long as you can kind of imagine or just intend this in your mind, it'll work for you. So imagine that you're inside of a bubble, whether you're sitting, moving around, or standing. This bubble is your aura. At the bottom of your aura, imagine that there is a pipe gently attached at the bottom that leads all the way deep down into the earth. You can imagine roots or anything else if you prefer. Now, for the sake of simplicity, imagine that your bubble is full of a dark colored energy. Now, as you breathe, you can use your hands to gesture it, but imagine in your mind or intend that this dark colored energy is kind of like water and it slowly drains out of your bubble, out through the bottom, and is released deep into the earth. Intend to release all energy that does not belong to you, all foreign energy. Intend to release all energy that is not serving your highest good and that is not serving your true will. It's leaving all of the layers of your aura, every part of your body, all your chakras, every little area and part of your energy is draining out. All toxic connections, all emotional blocks, they're draining out. And then just continue to see it drain out until the last bit leaves at the bottom. And just imagine or intend closing the bottom of the aura and see that pipe or whatever attachment is at the bottom just kind of roll away, crumble away, or just disintegrate and disappear. And feel again yourself in this bubble. You have just grounded your energy. I'm going to use a singing bowl to do a little clearing to assist in kind of brushing off anything that is not serving you. Done that. If you continue to stick with us through the report, we will also be doing a healing to put energy back in where we have removed energy. And at the end, we will be casting a protection and setting an intention for our day. But now we are going to be talking about the day's astrology.
Everyone says good morning. We have our community here with us this morning. This was a handful of individuals hiding out in the background. So just say hello to
That's
everyone.
All right. Hello all, and welcome. So, the Sun, Jupiter, Saturn, and Pluto are in Capricorn. These planets are encouraging us to make decisions for ourselves, be the leader of our own lives, and to decide the course of our own lives. So these are all about creating transformation and opportunities by exercising self-sufficiency, independence, and solving our problems. Mars in Sagittarius comes to help in that we have a drive and a push of initiative towards exploring possibility for ourselves and discovering more for ourselves in our lives rather than just settling for what is and what's comfortable. And along with that, we have Uranus in Taurus. This revolutionary planet is here to kind of shake up the habits and the comfort zone that has rooted itself deeply in our consciousness and to encourage us to make changes. Mercury is in Aquarius, so mentally, the way that we think, the way that we express ourselves, and the way that we communicate with others is we are influenced to think outside the box, to seek something different, something that is perhaps unique to us, and seeking a greater sense of what we're doing. Venus and Neptune are in Pisces, and these are rooting our heart very, even more deeply in our emotions than usual, in our love life and in our relationships. We are seeking depth and sincerity, but we need to kind of contend with fantasy and illusions. So we may find that depth where we are looking for, but we need to be mindful if we are really seeing the person in front of us as who they are right now, or if we're just looking at potential, or if we are completely under illusion here. Neptune is in Pisces as well. So our deeper intuitions and instinctual senses are rising to consciousness. So we may be more aware of our instincts at this time and more connected to our emotions. The moon is in Scorpio. So we are feeling a need for authenticity, for depth, for passion, to experience transformation. Of course, we want change in our lives. On its negative side, we may also be feeling more bitter, more resentful, and more vengeful or vindictive at this time. How we respond to influences is up to us. The moon in Scorpio connects us more deeply to where our passion lives. And even if you are feeling that negative side of it, you can choose to transform. So that is definitely what Scorpio is all about. Let's look at the aspects for today. So the moon is sextile with the Sun, Saturn, and Pluto, which are all in Capricorn. So whichever side of the moon you're on, whether it's the shadow side with bitterness and resentfulness, or on its positive side, which is passion, transformation, and intensity, depth. Well, both sides are intense, but depth. Either way, you can use that as fuel to accomplish what the planets in Capricorn are asking of us, to become the leader of our lives, to make changes, to not wait for other people or the situation to change, to make a decision about what we want and to do something. To be our own leader, to be our own parent figure, to decide and then figure things out, not wait for things to figure themselves out or someone else to guide us for things to be clear. We've got to take the first step. So, yes. That is the astrology for today.
Fantastic.
So, next we will be talking about the numerology.
Well, it's a one day.
It is a one day.
One day is a fantastic day.
On this one day, it's all about independence. By the way, today is Sunday, January 19th. Didn't see that earlier. It is a day to try something new or explore new places, meet new people, or spend time with a friend who will encourage you to step outside of your comfort zone. If you're feeling stressed today, it's a day to move your body, get some exercise, or even just dance. Trust yourself and your intuition. Be original, creative, and divine. It's pretty much like the astrology in a nutshell. I could have just skipped that and read the numerology. So it's like all the same stuff. In essence.
Yeah,
stressed is one way that you could put to Moon in Scorpio. You might feel more stressed.
The important thing to remember is that when we're feeling stressed, we carry it in our bodies. We carry it in our shoulders, in our backs. We feel fatigued. And the thing to remember is that getting up, going for a walk, moving your body, whether you're dancing around your house to your favorite tunes, or going to the mall and just walking up and down and window shopping with a friend, when we feel stressed, moving your body is the best way to release that stress, get that energy, you know, in motion again, so it's not sitting on top of you and suffocating you. And I think that is definitely something we need to keep in mind with the planets sitting where they are today.
Oh, you were talking.
I was. I'm done.
All right. So, next is our crystal healing of the day. The crystal we are working with today is called ametrine. It is a combination of amethyst and citrine. They sometimes grow or develop together because they're actually just both quartz and different minerals and things that happen in the earth give them their color and the changes in their chemical structure. So I'm going to tell you a little bit about ametrine before we get started. Ametrine is a powerful combination of amethyst and citrine, connecting physical and spiritual realms. Ametrine is a very soothing stone, believed to be valuable with those with chronic long-term diseases. Ametrine can be used to enhance creativity and learning. Ametrine combines masculine and feminine energy and helps bring harmony with others. Many people use ametrine for stress relief. Ametrine helps to remove negativity and blockages from the physical body, as well as the auric field, filling the area with light and energy of love and healing. Obviously, it has all the qualities of amethyst and of citrine and of quartz. So it is quite a stone. If you'd like to experience the energy of this crystal for yourself, just allow yourself to connect with the energy of this crystal while the healing happens. So I will go ahead and begin the healing now. layers. And down. Down to the feet. Sending healing to your path. Healing to your soul and spirit. Filling the space that we cleared out earlier. Sending healing to the chest and heart area. And then along the back, starting from the top and going down. Spine. Now I'm going to move to each of your hands. I'm going to start with the left hand. To open the hand. Just let it go. Sending healing energy to increase your ability to receive. Now, the right hand, we're going to open that as well. Breathe and let it go. I'm going to send healing here to encourage your ability to create, to achieve. Finally, the throat. I'm going to encourage movement of energy here. To express your will, to speak your truth. This concludes the crystal healing with Ametrine. Sending you one last verse. Be still in the healing energy you've received. We will now be moving into our affirmation for the day. So this affirmation comes from the book Heal Your Body by Louise Hay, and this one addresses pimples or other forms of breakouts such as blackheads, etc. Even if this isn't something you struggle with, it is a helpful affirmation. I'm going to say this affirmation to you first so you can hear the words and take it in, and we will say it together. I calm my thoughts, and I am serene. Now we are going to say this together 3 times. I calm my thoughts, and I am serene. I calm my thoughts, and I am serene. I calm my thoughts, and I am serene. I encourage you to take this affirmation with you in your day. This concludes the affirmation.
It is affirmable.
It is a simple thing, but it's good to do that each day, some kind of affirmation pertaining to what you want to create for yourself or to change. All right. So now it is time for our magic tip of the day. Today's magic tip pertains to the sun and sunlight. The moon kind of gets all of the attention when it comes to charging our tools and charging our crystals and ourselves with its energy, but you can do the same thing with the sun. So you can leave your things out, please. If you leave your crystals out in the sunlight, just be sure you look up your crystal, because some of them are heat sensitive, and I have had crystals explode. However, the sun is very powerful, so really it only needs to be in the sun for a few seconds to charge with its energy and to clear. At least I have found. You can leave it out there for as long as you like, but it really only takes about 9 seconds to charge something or to clear something using sunlight. You can also clear and charge your own energy using the sun. And it's very simple. You just stand outside in the direct sunlight and ask it to remove from you all energy that doesn't belong to you or whatever type of energy you'd like to see go, and turn around slowly to each side. And it doesn't take very long, maybe 1 or 2 minutes. And it is a helpful and extremely simple way to clear your energy each day. And you don't have to do it that way while you're just outside walking about. You can in your own mind intend that the sunlight clears you while you are walking from one place to another and just happen to be outside.
But we have a question. Is that a good way to clear cards as well?
Yes. I find it's especially good for tools. I used to clear my scrying mirrors that way. If you use mirrors, you should definitely clean them in sunlight after every use. More about that another day, but it is excellent for clearing. So yeah, that's the magic tip. Sunlight, it's a resource available to us every single day, so take advantage.
Fantastic.
Sun water is just as good. Yeah. All right.
It's great. I always clear myself with sunlight. I've always been solar oriented. I'm not as deeply connected to that lunar energy.
Not everyone is lunar. Some people have a more solar spirituality or essence in their nature. So you may, if you've never really connected with the moon or like the energy, just, you know, is kind of
right.
Meh. It's like, well, I guess I'll do it because that's what you do. Try sunlight.
Yeah, absolutely. Danielle asks, how do I go about laying them out? I wouldn't lay them out in the sun. I would take the deck out and draw one card at a time and turn it back and forth in the sunlight and then move on to the next card. I wouldn't leave them laying outside.
Yeah. Again, I know we're not used to that. In the moonlight, you leave stuff out like overnight or for hours. The sun, it really is very powerful. It only takes a few seconds. So a few seconds on each card, or, I mean, really, depending on how deep of a cleanse, that'll definitely cleanse them all the way. You can just, like,
shuffle them out there.
Kind of, like, open them in front of the sun.
Yeah. If you want to get a good clearing, I recommend going one card at a time and just turning them over in the sunlight so that you're getting both sides. That way you get a nice, deep cleaning out of them. Sandy says that she's very interested about scrying, so maybe we could talk about that another day.
Yep, so that'll be a discussion later. I have my tips lined up for a while, so can expect that in February. In February we're going to talk about scrying.
Sounds good. Another interesting fact, just real quick, while we're on the topic of sunlight. I actually mentioned yesterday that my practice is based in Shintoism, and the goddess Amaterasu is the Shinto goddess of the sun. And she is actually invoked for clearing away negativity and evil and blessing you with light and love. So go out into that sun and get some of that light and love. That's my little addition to that. Making a note of the...
Yeah, I'm actually going to move a tip, so we'll talk about that on the new moon. I'm moving the tip I have for that day to another time.
All right.
That's... Okay. Yeah.
Alrighty. So I'm moving to our card reading for the day.
Yes.
Our card reading for the day.
So this is a reading for the collective, giving you some guidance, things to keep in mind in the day ahead. Alright. Am I supposed to do something else?
No, I just brought you your beads because I wanted mine.
Alright.
So it's okay. But I didn't have it. And yours was trapped with mine, so I didn't. I would just take it. There you go.
Alright. I'll expand my tarot collection again. I don't know. Well, I read clairvoyantly primarily, so it's just like, why have 10 decks?
I have a fun conversation ahead of me about maybe trading for a new deck. It's been too long. I only own 5 right now, so
between the two of us, we used to own like over 20.
Mm-hmm. I know. There are days where I'm like, I just don't want to work with any of the ones I have. No.
I'm happy with the ones I have, but just, I don't know.
More is more?
Variety is interesting. I'm very happy with Chico and stuff. I'm good.
Awesome.
Let's see what the cards have to say to us today. This card and an image in my mind. This is the Wheel of Fortune. I didn't know if you wanted to hold it up for them. Okay. So, the image is, I'll talk about the card first. So, this is the Wheel of Fortune, and it describes being caught in a cycle of our own karma. Karma in the sense of things happened, you reacted to those things, your actions in reacting created consequences and effects, and you reacted to those, more stuff happened, you react, more stuff happened, and it's like the consequences and results of your actions just kind of keep building up, and you just keep responding almost reflexively to them, and it kind of creates the cycle in which you are trapped. And this is what is known as fate, is the natural consequences of what has come before. You can detach yourself from this cycle. You can step out of this merry-go-round. You can step outside of this fate. But you have to choose it and make a strong decision rather than continuing to react, to just take action. You need to step outside of things, outside of yourself, and look at everything and make a decision about what you want and where you want to go, rather than continually responding to what's around you. So that is the Wheel of Fortune card. Now the image I received was of seeing a woman facing not sure what she's doing because it's like a really close-up picture of the focus is it a diadem?
Oh gosh.
A crown-like object.
Mm-hmm.
So let's just say a crown for simplicity, but like a feminine version of it. And it's on a cushion, and there's like the sense of this, your power is kind of like put away, put aside, being kept safe in a little container, not being used. But it's something that should be worn, and you should own it and take it for yourself. And I'm not sure exactly, it's kind of interesting, it's almost like the sense of even though it's yours, there's this feeling of like not being allowed to touch it, which really should never be the case, because it belongs to you. So these two ideas together is that you're kind of caught in this cycle, and it'll keep continuing until you make a decision to step out of it, and you need to utilize your power rather than continuing to have it kept away like a prized object, and to move forward. Let's see if the cards have anything else they'd like to say. have the King of Swords. The Chariot. And the Magician. So the King of Swords, this talks about bringing thought, planning, and intellect, bringing strategy to a situation. You need to use your minds to stop reacting from your emotions and just responding and reacting. Yeah, you get the point. It's just like, I want to make the point so strongly. Stop reacting emotionally. Think. Plan. Strategize. Really think about things. That is what that means. Tap into the mind. The third eye doesn't just pertain to your intuition, but to your intellect.
Sorry, multitasking.
The Chariot. This talks about taking the reins of your life into your own hands, and that you need to be decisive, and that by being decisive, you not only help yourself, but you help others. And the Magician says that you have the power within you. It's like caged away, hidden. But it is in you, and you need to tap into your own power and bring it into the situation and use it to direct your life. So that is the card reading for today. If anyone would like to explore what came up in this reading for them, with more time, I do offer private readings, and you can contact me through my page to follow up on this reading. All right.
Hashtag more cats.
Hashtag more cats. Hey, I'm done.
Here's that baby. Oh, you are just so picture perfect on camera. You want that baby to...
She wants you.
She usually wants me. She doesn't like that I don't have my own desk anymore.
Oh, poor thing. All right, so now it is time for the question for the viewers of the day. This is the Kitchen Witches segment.
Oh no. Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you have a question for everyone today?
So today is a one day. We've gotten a lot of positive messages from the universe today about stepping out, being your own person, being all that you can be, finding that inner magic deep down. We've been talking about dipping down. So my question of the day is, what do you do each day to get in touch with your inner power?
And if you aren't doing anything, that is an answer that is relevant as well.
So this is the question of the day. What do you do each day to get in touch with your inner power? I did have a question. I just had to remember what.
Yeah.
I do a lot of multitasking.
Nice, sweet cat.
So, Lysander, what do you do each day to get in touch with your inner power? That's just for you. I know you get in touch with your inner power all day, every day, but that's just for you.
So something I do every day is centering myself. That may sound simplistic, but it's like, even if it's just for a moment, being still and bringing my attention to the present moment, and to draw my attention within, here where their soul is, and to connect with how it is I'm feeling in that moment, and with my sense of deeper identity and my place.
Leo says meditation. Meditation is a great way for us to get in touch with our inner selves, our like inner power. I personally like to, I'm sure I've mentioned a few times, I like to dance around. I get in touch with my inner power by listening to music, moving my body, dancing, and just really letting that music kind of take me. It really helps me feel that power deep inside of me.
Music is a very powerful tool for getting in touch with oneself and one's sense of power, if it is used that way.
Yeah. Carla says, meditation, grounding, and a walk. That is a great way to do it. Again, that moving your body, generating that energy. Joe adds, and grounding. Yes, absolutely. Movement is energy. Everything we do magically, everything we do spiritually, it is energy. And when we move our bodies, we're generating more energy.
Yes. It is important to get in touch with your own power each day. To get in touch with you and what you feel like. Because if you don't know what you feel like, you can't tell when you're being invaded or attacked or something is wrong or amiss. And if you can't tell that something is amiss, then you can't correct it. And that's like an essential part of defense, as well as empowering yourself and moving forward.
So Danielle says, daydreaming, baths, drive.
Great.
Those are great answers. Carla asks, how do you center yourself?
So, this is what I do. So, whatever I'm doing, wherever I am, I bring my attention to my body first. And just not, I don't really go into it. It's as fast as I'm telling you now, just awareness of it. And I pay attention to what I hear around me. There are birds outside. Occasional car, the tinkling of mallow beans, the smells around me. I actually have a poor sense of smell, so I don't smell much typically. If I have my eyes open, just like what I see around me, I'm in my room, where I am, when I am, and then I bring my attention to who I am, I like my name, just the sense of my own energy, and I draw my attention further inward into my soul self and what I know of that. And sometimes I might accompany that with a visualization of walking downstairs into the deep darkness, because that is my spiritual basis, is the empty dark, and meet myself there. Sometimes as another figure or a reflection in the mirror, or just myself, and I just sit in that space. Or sometimes I just sit in the black emptiness, because that is what I relate to the most. Everyone is different.
Everyone has their own.
So essentially it's just bringing yourself present and drawing your attention inward, mentally, psychologically going inside. So I hope that makes sense. That's the quickest way I can explain it. And don't overthink it. I do it as quickly as I just told it to you.
Okay. I wish there was enough space to see the comments more. Hold on, let me switch computers really quick. Got comments coming in, so I'm not able to read it. Here we go. Okay. Indigo says, my mind tends to wander a lot lately. I find that Oracle cards bring me back and help me center my thoughts. I don't use them to make decisions, but rather to meditate on the scenarios and messages presented to me.
That's an excellent use of cards.
I think that's fantastic.
Should note that down. Other uses for cards, because they can be used for a lot of other things than just reading.
I do something similar from time to time, especially if I've got a lot of thoughts on my mind. I'll sit with my cards and I'll shuffle and see if they have commentary to my thoughts. Kind of nice. Definitely makes things a little easier. Hello, Andy. And everyone says thank you for sharing.
You're welcome. Alright. So,
Thank you all for sharing your answers to that question of the day. I hope you're enjoying the question of the day.
Yes,
we are definitely enjoying having you share with us.
So we're going to do announcements and then close with a protection and intention setting. Arush keeps knocking the camera. You're wondering why it jolts suddenly. Alright, so announcements. If you enjoyed watching the Morning Metaphysical Report, please like and follow or subscribe to my page or channel. This content happens because of support from viewers like yourself. So if you would like to learn more about the Morning Metaphysical Report and how you can contribute, please visit patreon.com/freedomdreamcoaching. I'm sure that as you could tell from the opening screen and so on, we are making some changes. And you will see more of those coming. They're all great things that are going to enable us to offer you more value and to offer you more transformation and change in your life. So we're very excited.
Yeah, I just want to take a moment to say we were so blessed to work with a photographer yesterday. We're so blessed to be working with an editor. We're so blessed to be working with a graphic designer. It's been truly beautiful and truly divine. We just want to put that gratitude out there as well.
Yes. All right. I think that is all for the announcements.
Yeah, I do think so. Did you mention book club?
No. So book club is after the morning report. So anyone who would like to continue hearing from the book All Is Well by Louise Hay and Mona Lisa Schultz, please join me for that. And stick around my page for a few minutes after the report. Right, so we are going to move into the protection. I'm going to cast a protection for you as you go about your day to assist you no matter who it is you interact with going to work, or for those of you who are also psychics and healers, to protect you and your own sacred space as you serve others today. So if you would like to receive this protection, just allow yourself to receive it. So now, let us set an intention for our day. You can accept my intention that I set for yourself, or you can go ahead and set one for your day now. It's a very positive thing to do at the beginning of each day, and you'll be surprised what it can bring. We all come from Source. Everything comes from Source, so therefore anything that is of Source is also ours to have as well. Today, we are experiencing abundance. Today, we are experiencing flow and ease. Today, we are experiencing clarity and healing. Today, we are experiencing an inflow of what is in our highest good, and all things happen as they need to happen, and we allow it, and we are grateful for these things. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And so it is. Be blessed.
Blessings, love, and light on your journey today. Namaste.
Be blessed.